Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 22 in Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. We are going to discuss the topic Flow with Normal Shock, Part 1. In the earlier lectures, In gas dynamics and jet propulsion, we studied the isentropic flow, Fanner flow, Rayleigh flow and isothermal flow, and we solved the problem in all the types of flows to understand the property variation in the various flows. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss the flow with the normal shock. We will be focusing on types of shock waves and the governing equations. We derive the Prandtl-Meyer equation and we calculate the Mach number downstream of the shock wave. The learning outcome to the students: at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to classify the shock waves, derive the Prandtl-Meyer equation, which is the important equation for the shock waves, flow through shock waves, and calculate the Mach number downstream of the shock. A shock wave is defined as a special kind of pressure wave with a steep pressure rise. When there is a shock, there will be steep pressure rise across the shock. The shock wave will occur in the fluid, for example, water and the gas. And in this subject, we are dealing with gas, so the shock wave occurs in the gas. A very simple example to understand what is a shock wave is, the wave occurs in the sea, like your tsunami waves. So across the tsunami wave, there is a steep pressure rise that is occurring in the fluid. Similarly, those who are not familiar with the tsunami, and you take a small bucket of water and drop a stone at the middle, you may find circular waves are formed, and the circular waves are moving towards the outer circumference and they hit the surface of the bucket. When the magnitude of the wave is very high, it will even damage the wall, it will damage the bucket. The shock wave, across the shock wave, there is sharp increase in pressure. The pressure rise will be very high across the shock wave. The shock wave will occur when the flow transition takes place from supersonic condition to the subsonic condition. So in the gas dynamics. So the supersonic condition to subsonic condition, normally it occurs in the diffuser. So in the supersonic subsonic diffuser, converging diverging diffuser, so definitely there will be a shock wave. So across the shock wave, there will be more pressure rise. So whenever there is a transition of flow from supersonic condition to the subsonic condition, that is Mach number greater than 1 to Mach number less than 1, there will be a shock wave. So across the shock wave, abrupt change in the property occurs across the shock wave, particularly pressure. There will be very high pressure rise across the shock wave. The fluid experiences non-linear variation of properties across the shock wave. Whereas in the Fanner flow, Rayleigh flow, there will be linear change in the properties. But in the shock wave, the properties are changing non-linearly. Some of the examples for the shock waves: flow in turbomachines, particularly in the air compressor and the gas turbine. So air compressor and gas turbine, between the blade passage, there is a possibility of shock wave. So we have to carefully design the turbomachines such a way that the shock wave will not occur in the turbomachine. Blast waves occurring during the explosion of bomb. So we know the effect of the atom bomb, effect of missile. When you put a bomb in a particular place, there is sudden change in the pressure. So that the pressure change, it causes the temperature change. That is why there is a firing. There is firing when there is bomb blast. So the pressure change suddenly increases the temperature, so which causes the firing. And the exhaust system of reciprocating engine. So the gases are leaving with very high velocity, so that causes the pressure change, sudden pressure change, that is also shock waves are produced on the exhaust system of the reciprocating engine. So these are all the some of the examples for the shock waves, the physical appearance of the shock wave, and this is the normal shock. So normal shock, which is perpendicular to the direction of the flow. So this is moving normal shock, and this is the explosion of a bomb. So here there is no normal shock, but the shocks are in, that is called as oblique shock. So in this lecture we will be discussing about the normal shock. In the subsequent lecture we'll deal with the oblique shock. And this is again a bullet released from the gun. It is moving, so you may find the shock waves. And this is the flow of a missile, which causes the tremendous pressure rise in the gas atmospheric air. This is also which causes the shock wave. These are all the few examples of. So in all the shock wave, the pressure rise is very high. There are different types of shock waves. So one type of one classification is the shock wave may be normal, oblique, or curved. So in the normal shock wave, it is perpendicular to the direction of the flow. Oblique shock wave, they are inclined, and the curved shock waves, they are with a curve. So in this lecture, we will be discussing about the normal shock wave, oblique shock wave, curved shock wave, we'll take up later. And this is stationary shock wave. So this is a body, for example, a jet engine. At the front of the jet engine, there will be a shock wave, or a missile which is moving, or an aircraft which is moving. At the front of the aircraft, there will be a shock wave. That is, the shock wave is stationary. And here, in the case of a explosion at the entrance of a duct, so the wave is formed and it is moving. This is called as moving shock wave. So the shock wave may be stationary shock wave or moving shock wave, normal shock wave, oblique shock wave, or curved shock wave. And these are all the classification according to the angular position. This may be normal shock wave, oblique shock wave, curved shock wave. According to the motion, this may be stationary shock wave or moving shock wave. There is another classification according to the strength. This may be weak wave or strong wave. So the weak waves are further classified into weak compression waves and weak expansion waves. Schlieren photograph of flow is used to study the physical nature of the shock wave. So this is the study, a image taken using the Schlieren photograph technique, which is used to study the flow, physical behavior of the flow with a shock wave. And in the normal shock wave, we assume certain things to understand the property variation across the shock wave. These are all the assumptions. The flow is steady and one dimensional. The gas behaves as perfect gas and the properties are constant. The shock wave is very thin. The magnitude is very small in micron level thickness, and it can be considered to take place across in a constant area duct. So it is occurring in a constant area. The flow is considered as frictionless flow. The flow is considered as adiabatic flow and there is no external work. So when there is friction, frictionless flow, that means isentropic flow. When there is friction, it is Fanon flow. When there is heat transfer, there is Rayleigh flow. So we want to study the effect of shock alone. So that is why we assume that it is frictionless flow. And the flow is considered as adiabatic and there is no external work and body forces are negligible. That is, the effect of gravitational forces are negligible. And if we derive the governing equation for the shock wave, we take a control volume, constant area duct. We assume that there is a normal shock wave standing at the pipe, in the cross section of the pipe. The thickness is dx, very, very small. We said it is very thin. The thickness of the shock wave is in microns. And the flow rate is M, and we have the properties on the downstream and the upstream and the downstream side of the duct. On the upstream side, we have Cx velocity, Mx Mach number, Px property, Tx temperature, Pox and Rox. They are the Pox is stagnation pressure, Rox is the density. Similarly, on the other side, we have all the properties. We have to take the three equations, continuity equation, momentum equation, and the energy equation to study the behavior of the flow in the shock wave. We take the continuity equation for the flow across the control volume, M equal to rho x, ax, cx, rho a, v, rho a, c is the mass flow rate, rho x, ax, cx equal to rho y, ay, cy. rho is the density, A is the area, cross-sectional area, and C is the velocity. And for constant area duct, the mass flux is given by M by A equal to rho x Cx equal to rho y Cy. And for adiabatic flow with no external work done, the steady flow energy equation HOx equal to HOy is constant. For flow through duct with normal shock, we remember that HOx equal to HOy. Stagnation enthalpy remains constant. So HOx equal to Hx plus Cx square by 2 and HOy equal to HOy plus Cy square by 2. And neglecting the frictional forces, the body forces and the shear forces, the momentum equation becomes Px minus Py into A equal to M into Cy minus Cx. So first one is continuity equation and second one is energy equation. Third is the momentum equation. So momentum equation is written like this. Px minus Py into A equal to M into Cy minus Cx. And the Px minus Py equal to M by A Cy minus Cx. And substituting for M by A, we'll get Px plus rho x Cx square equal to Py plus rho y Cy square. We know Px plus rho x Cx square equal to Fx and Py plus rho y Cy square equal to Fy. So Fx equal to Fy. So the impulse function is constant across the shock wave. So these are all the governing equation. And this is the occurrence of shock wave in the Rayleigh flow and the Fanner flow. So we know the Fanner curve. We have a Fanner curve and we have a Rayleigh curve, Rayleigh line. And we know that the upper branch of the curve is subsonic in both the Fanner flow and the Rayleigh flow. And the lower branch of the curve is supersonic flow for both the flow, Fanner flow and Rayleigh flow. Now, the flow changes from subsonic to supersonic by means of a shock wave. For example, you take the Fanner flow. So, the flow properties are decreasing. So, this is subsonic region. Suddenly, there is a shock wave. And it becomes, supersonic region, suddenly there is a shock wave, the flow becomes subsonic and then the further properties are changing. Similarly for Rayleigh flow, the supersonic condition, there is heat transfer, sudden change in the pressure, it causes the pressure rise, then it becomes, again there is heat transfer in the Rayleigh, follows the Rayleigh line. So this is the three flows, flow Fanner line, Rayleigh flow and with the normal shock. So, we will take up the problem with the Fanner flow and Rayleigh flow with the shock wave, later stages. And the Prandtl-Meyer equation, the derivation of Prandtl-Meyer equation is an important equation for the shock wave, normal shock wave. The adiabatic energy equation is given. So, in the first chapter, we derived the equation A square by gamma minus 1 plus C square by 2 equal to A star square by 2 into gamma plus 1 by gamma minus 1. This is adiabatic energy equation, which we derived in the first chapter when we discussed the properties, energy equation, particularly adiabatic energy equation. Applying this equation before and after the normal shock, we will get Ax square by gamma minus 1 plus Cx square by 2 is equal to Ay square by gamma minus 1 plus Cy square by 2 is equal to A star square by 2 into gamma plus 1 by gamma minus 1. So, we take the first part. What is the first part? Ax square by gamma minus 1 plus Cx square by 2 equal to, we take the last term, A star square by 2 into gamma plus 1 by gamma minus 1. So, this is the equation for the upstream side of the shock wave or before the shock wave. Now, rearrange the equation, Ax square by gamma minus 1 plus Cx square by 2 equal to A star square by 2 into gamma plus 1 by gamma minus 1. This is the term and rearranging Ax square by Cx. Ax square by Cx equal to gamma plus 1 by 2 into A star square by Cx minus Cx into gamma minus 1 by 2. Similarly, Ay square by Cy, rearranging the terms, Ay square by Cy, similar fashion, gamma plus 1 by 2, A star square by Cy minus Cy into gamma minus 1 by 2. We call this as equation number 1 and equation number 2. The momentum equation for the flow with the shock wave for constant area duct. So, we said Px minus Py into A by M equal to Cy minus Cx. Now, A by M equal to 1 by rho x Cx, which is equal to 1 by rho y Cy. Substituting in the above equation, Px by rho x Cx minus Py by rho y Cy equal to Cy minus Cx. Now, multiply by gamma. So, gamma Px divided by rho x Cx minus gamma Py by rho y Cy equal to gamma into Cy minus Cx. Now P by rho into C, P by rho into C is equal to gamma into Px by rho x equal to Ax square. Right? So this is how P by rho equal to RT, P by rho equal to RT, gamma RT equal to, gamma RT equal to A square, Ax square. So this is Ax square divided by, so this gamma Px by rho x equal to Ax square. So similarly, gamma Py by rho equal to Ay square. So P by rho equal to RT. So numerator will become gamma RT. Gamma RT equal to Ax square divided by Cx. So this is, so this value is Ax square. Now substituting Ax square by Cx minus Ay square by Cy equal to gamma into Cy minus Cx. This Ax square by Cx, Ay square by Cy already we derived. So substituting from equation number 1 and 2, 1 and 2, 1 equation number 1 we derived as Ax square by Cx, equation number 2 is Ay square by Cy. Substituting here, this will be gamma plus 1 by 2 A star square by Cx minus gamma minus 1 by 2 Cx minus gamma plus 1 by 2 A star square by Cy plus gamma minus 1 by 2 Cy equal to gamma into Cy minus Cx. And simplifying this equation, we will get A star square equal to Cx Cy. So the derivation is there in between. You may, if you want derivation, you may refer to my book, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. You may find the derivation, but it is very simple arithmetic calculation. You can do the calculation and you will get A star square equal to Cx Cy, and this is known as Prandtl-Meyer equation. A star square equal to the acoustic velocity, A star is the acoustic velocity at the sonic condition, Cx and Cy are the velocity upstream and the downstream of the shock wave. Cx is the velocity on the upstream side, Cy is the velocity on the downstream side, that is before the shock and after the shock. And this equation we can rearrange. So this is Cx by Cy divided by A star square. So Cx Cy by A star into A star is equal to 1. So Cx by A star equal to mx star, and Cy by A star equal to my star equal to 1. So this above equation is another form of Prandtl-Meyer equation for normal shock. So this equation is very important conclusion for normal study the behavior of the normal shock wave. And we calculate the Mach number. Normally in all the problem will be given Mach number on the upstream side. Mx value will be given. We have to calculate My, that is Mach number on the downstream side of the shock wave. So for adiabatic energy equation, we have A star square equal to 2 gamma by gamma plus 1 RTO. So this is the from the adiabatic energy equation once again. This adiabatic energy equation we studied in the first chapter. Properties of stagnation properties. So in that chapter we studied the adiabatic energy equation. Now substituting in the Prandtl-Meyer equation, Cx Cy equal to 2 gamma by gamma plus 1 RTO. So it will be mx into square root of gamma RTx into my into square root of gamma RTy equal to 2 gamma by gamma plus 1 RTO. So squaring the entire value, mx square plus my square equal to 2 by gamma plus 1 whole square plus 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 mx square plus 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 my square tx ty. So this will be simplifying the above equation, the Mach number will be, and downstream side will be my square equal to 2 by gamma minus 1 plus mx square divided by 2 gamma by gamma minus 1 mx square minus 1. So this is the value. You need to know the max number on the upstream side, you can calculate the Mach number on the downstream side. So here again, in between we have the derivation. So the derivation you can refer to the book. And this is how the Mach number is varying. So when you know the Mach number on the upstream side, so Mach number on the downstream side, we plot the variation in the form of a graph, mx in the x-axis, my in the y-axis. So this is how the Mach number is varying. So Mach number decreases on the downstream side. That means the flow become the supersonic to when we have mx equal to 8 here, and the my value will be, this is the value of my. So for mx equal to 8 and my will be equal to 0.45 or 0.5. So the Mach number is changing, suddenly changing across the shock wave. So we stop here. So these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering. You may find the book Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. You refer to the book for your additional for additional information in the subject and the detailed derivation of the Prandtl-Meyer equation or any other mathematical derivation. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So we'll continue the calculation of property variation across the normal shock wave in the next lecture.